Hi guys, welcome to Video Likes, and today I'm going to show you how you can lock a folder without the help of any software using only your notepad. So what I have here is a notepad with a very simple bash program written on it, and what you need to do is you need to just copy this entire program and paste it on a fresh notepad. Now, after you are done pasting, you just need to scroll down and look for the word your password. Okay, this is where it is. Now, in place where your password is written, you can put your own desired password of your choice. Now, for the sake of this example, I will put the password here as 123. Now I'll go to File and I'll click Save As. Now here I can select the drive where I want. From the top I can select the drive where I want my locked folder to be. It can be any drive. And in the drop down below as Save As Type, I'll select as All Files. And I'll put the name here as locker.bat. The BAT extension is very important, guys. You cannot save it as a text file. So you need to put the .bat extension. So it's locker.bat. And I'll save it on my desktop here. Okay, so this is my file. And I'll now close the notepad. Now watch what happens when I double click on locker.bat file. You see that it creates a folder called the locker. Now, I'm just going to open this folder here. And I'm going to put in some pictures. Okay, I'm going to drag and drop them. That's it. Now, what I'm going to do here is, I'm going to click on locker.bat once again. Now, when I click on locker.bat once again, it's giving me a prompt that whether I want to lock the folder, I have to answer with a Y for a yes or a no. So I click on Y and you see that the folder gets locked and hidden. It's nowhere to be seen on the desktop. Now, if I want to retrieve the folder once again, now what I need to do is I need to click on locker.bat file once again. And this time, it's asking me for the password. Now, the password that I had put is 123. And you see that the folder comes back once again. So that's a great way, guys, of locking a folder. But however, it's got one constraint. Now, by the following the above method, you can hide a file. But someone with knowledge of editing a .bat file can easily edit your password and access the file. So I'll show you another method wherein you can change this .bat extension to an executable file format. Now for this, I will be using a software called BAT to .exe converter. So I'll open this particular software here. And you see right on top, I can select the batch file. I'll go to my desktop and select the locker file and I'll click on compile. Now once I click on compile, you see that this particular file comes up, which is a .exe file, and what I can do is I can now delete the locker file. Now if I double click on this particular .exe file, you see that it's doing the same functions as the locker.bat file. So hope this tutorial will be of help to you. If you have any query, please put in your comments below and I would be glad to answer them. If you like my videos, do please put in your likes and subscribe to my channel, Video Likes. Catch you again in the next video. Till then, bye-bye.